Good morning, good afternoon, or good night, or whatever time it may be in your part of the world. My name is Mr. John Wayne, and I am a variety gamer. I play everything from the Fallout franchise all the way to the Soulsborne series. Welcome, everybody, to another episode of my Final Fantasy 16 Let's Play. I hope you're all doing well. I know that I am, and today we're going to start with some side quests and hopefully get on to the main quest. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started.
I've never even forged a butter knife. Perhaps Forge Master Luba's having fun at my expense.
I wouldn't put it past him.
Neither would I.
Oh, wait. Are you Clive?
Sorry, my mind was elsewhere. I'm Sava, Master Luba's least accomplished apprentice. Soon to be former apprentice if I don't pass this test. Maybe I'm just not the resourceful type. People are buying up weapons faster than the Briar's Kiss can forge them, and here I am, unable to make a decent bit of kitchenware. He wants me to make a carving knife, one that embodies the spirit of Dalamil. Whatever that's supposed to mean. I don't suppose you have any idea what he's on about, do you?
I'm afraid not.
Never mind. Thought I'd ask. It was that or pack my bags.
I could give you a hand if you like. I know how busy the Briar's Kiss has been, and that Lubor needs all the capable hands he can find.
I'd be a fool to refuse.
So, where do we start?
Good question. If I'm honest, I've never made any kind of knife before. And then there's this little riddle to keep in mind, the spirit of Dalamil. Nothing is ever simple with that man.
The way I see it, there's only one way we'll be solving Lupor's puzzle. We need information. The more the better.
You're right. There's no point fumbling in the dark, I suppose. Now, who to speak to first? There's plenty of folk in Dalamil who use knives for a living. There's the butcher, of course, and any number of cooks. They're bound to have an opinion or two about the tools of their trade. All right. I think we have a plan. Let's get to it, shall we? I'll talk to every cook I can find. You speak to the butcher and anyone else you can think of.
All right. Good luck.
Let's hope that someone says something useful.
Trust Lubor to take a simple test and turn it into a riddle. I'd better get to it.
It would make a fine gift.
Needed to a silken sock.
Welcome, sir. What can I do you for?
A question, if you don't mind. I need to know what makes a good carving knife.
You a blacksmith or something?
Something, I suppose.
Fair enough. Knives, is it? First and foremost, it's got to hold an edge. Most knives will make it through fat no problem, but sinew dulls cheap steel in no time. Give me a blade which can slice through anything that crosses my chopping block, and I'm a happy woman.
So a knife that stays sharp. Makes sense.
Okay. So somewhere in here we need to find somebody to talk to.
Made from the stoutest stoneware. Won't ship.
I'll be asking for you again, my sweet.
Then see that you stay a little longer.
Silver platters. Sweet incense.
Ha! They've opened the gate.
Lubor was true to his word.
Well, we can make our way back to the Fang now, at least.
Yeah, but what would be the...
What is it? Me no move for chatter.
Sorry. Do you mind if I ask your trade?
Hunter? Why?
I have a question. Can you tell me what makes a good carving knife? I assume you use one out in the field.
Has to be able to put up with some punishment. Can't be dealing with a brittle blade, not while I'm on the hunt. If your knife snaps every time you use it, you'll be spending coin as fast as you make it. Times are hard enough as it is.
Thank you. I won't keep you any longer.
All business, eh? Man after my own heart.
So, a carving knife should be hard-wearing and hold an edge. Hardly a revelation. Let's hope Sava had better luck than I did.
I doubt it, Clive.
Plates and pots! Bowls and basins!
Fresh bread, warm from the oven.
The most fragrant herbs and
the
spices.
The finest fabrics! Fresh from the...
So, how'd it go? You learn anything useful, or should I be looking for a new trade?
Only that a blade should be durable and stay sharp. But I don't see how that relates to the spirit of Dalamil.
I didn't have much luck either. All the cook said was that he needs his knives to be light. Too heavy, and they do his shoulder in.
So we're no better off than when we started. Perhaps Lubor didn't mean anything with his Dalamil remark. But that can't be right. I've bandied enough words with the man to know that he chooses them carefully. No. We must be missing something. Something right in front of our noses, most likely.
No doubt you're right, but I have to make a start soon. I can't put off making this knife forever.
Agreed. Luba wouldn't like that much.
Right. I've been trained to work iron. The cheap stuff, mind. But it's hardy enough if you don't hammer it too thin, and it sharpens up nicely with a bit of effort. Trouble is, it's either durable or it's light. Meaning someone is going to be disappointed. Forge Master Lubor, probably.
Is there no one else you can turn to? Someone who knows their metals, perhaps?
The other apprentices know better than to help me with my test. But maybe there is someone I could turn to. A merchant, a favorite of Forge Master Lubor's, who sells metals to tradesmen passing through the Valcroy. I bet she'd know a thing or two.
Oh, wow, that is kind of far. We'll hop on our chocobo.
Ready, girl?
Yeah!
I mean, I guess it's not really that far. It's just up the road, but if you're on foot, it feels like it's a little far. Oh, cool. Dust Devil.
So,
be safe.
Cook has finally made his move.
Yes. I expect that's why there's so many soldiers in town.
Any luck? Or will you be needing help with your bags?
Well, I asked her, but... you tell him.
If you're looking to make a knife that will impress a master like Lubor, there are options. They're just not that viable. Featherlight adamantite knives will get passed from generation to generation, never needing so much as a lick of the whetstone. But adamantite ore is unique to ash, so doesn't come cheap.
And it's beyond my skill to handle.
Unique to ash? Are there any materials unique to Dalamil? Something which could be mixed with iron to refine it? Make it lighter?
What are you getting at?
You said that Lubor trained you to work iron. Then that's what he'll expect you to use. But he would have known that it would either be too heavy or too brittle for a carving knife. Perhaps his Dalamil remark wasn't a riddle, but a hint.
If it's cheap metal you're using, then there's always limestone, I suppose. Folk first settled Dalamil to get at her mineral deposits. And if you know the trick, it can be melted down in the furnace to drive out impurities from low-quality iron.
Bloody hell! That must be it! I don't suppose you know the trick, do you?
It's hardly my speciality, but I've been around enough blacksmiths to know how it works.
Looks like I've got some learning to do. Clive, I hate to ask after all that you've done for me, but...
The limestone? Fine. I can hardly abandon you now. Besides, I want to know if this is the answer to Lubor's little riddle.
I can't thank you enough, Clive. You'll have no trouble finding limestone over in the terraces. The place is bloody made of it!
Then I suppose I'll meet you back at the forge.
Right you are. I'll see you shortly. So, do you crush it up, or just...
Just gonna check real quick if there's any chests or anything over here. Nope, don't see any. Good lord. We're going all over the place for this side quest. More than usual, that's for sure. Wonder if it'll make us get off our chocobo if we go towards the town, or if it'll rear up or something.
Back to the stables, girl.
Okay, well that answers my question.
Is it true what I'm hearing?
Yes, they're quite sort of.
Light meat and dark, fresh from the grill.
Made from the stoutest stoneware.
Just look at the
hanging lanterns. Keep the darkness from your door.
We should get going soon. Do you have water?
Ah, I'm not too late.
What is it, Lubor?
A question that I neglected to ask earlier. Where is it that you're bound?
To Drake's Fang. To finish Hugo Kupka.
Just as I thought. Then allow me to share a secret. Drake's Fang is currently riddled with royalists. Telmeki and Walud are allies, and as you have seen, their soldiers work hand in glove. But no nation has ever before allowed a foreign army to make a barracks of its holiest of holies.
Not by choice, at least.
And there's more. A man on the inside of the Fang has failed to report for several days. I fear there may be more trouble lying in wait for you on the road ahead.
Isn't there always?
If you're determined to beard the lion's den, then promise me one thing. That you will enter via the mines, where the guard is lightest. I've lost one Sid already. If I lose another, people will start to think me careless.
I don't plan on dying. Not before Kupka does, anyway.
Well, so long as you have a plan.
Drake's Fang should be just beyond these springs. Shall we press on?
I kind of figured there was going to be a cutscene as soon as I went through that gate.
One rock looks a lot like another. But hopefully this is what Sava needs.
We should get going soon. Do you have water?
Finally, we'll be able to get what's owed us.
Silver platters! Just... Needed to
the
a silken
meat
soffing.
Take
a sniff, good sir.
My carpets have brighter place in...
I wasn't sure how much you'd need, but I hope this is enough.
You are one of the good ones, you know that. You and that merchant both, she's got quite a gift for teaching, that one. Now, time to see if limestone is the secret weapon we were hoping for. That'll do, I reckon. A knife forged from the very rocks of Dalamil. Her spirit, if you will.
It's a fine-looking blade.
I only hope Master Lubor agrees.
That sounds like my cue. And just as well. I was getting tired of waiting.
I'm sorry, Forge Master Lubor.
Let's take a look then, shall we? First things first, Sava, do you think this is a carving knife worthy of the fine people of Dalamil?
I'd like to think so. But what do you think?
What do I think indeed? It's sharp-ish, but it won't last long with hard use. And it's heavy, heavier than it should be. You might not think it just to hold it for a moment, but sell that to a cook and you'll never hear the end of it. It looks like someone paid a visit to the terraces. The limestone was a step in the right direction, granted, but one that still leaves you short of the mark.
And I was so certain I had it all worked out.
I don't know who you found to teach you that little trick, but it certainly shows initiative. Next question. How much do you think I would charge if I'd made this?
Well, if it took you even a fraction of the time it took me, I would say you could demand a heavy purse.
And who would be able to pay that, hmm? The butcher? The hunter? The cooks over at the inn? Dalamil is home to humble traders, not wealthy lords and ladies. Rule number one in any business, Sava, know your customers.
Yes, Forge Master.
This is just about passable. But only just. I'd say you're worth keeping around a little longer. Starting tomorrow, you'll have an anvil of your own.
I will. Thank you. I was wondering, what would you do if you were asked to forge a carving knife?
I'd do what I always do. Ask who it's for. If it was for the butcher, I'd make sure it holds an edge. For the hunter, I'd make it as tough as Titan. For the cook, light as a feather. And for the nobleman, I'd make it cost an absolute fortune.
There goes a master, all right.
It looks like congratulations are in order.
I couldn't have done it without you. So much for the Forge Master's riddle, though, eh? The spirit of Dalamil had nothing to do with limestone or anything much at all. Meaning, I had you run around for no good reason.
You've passed your test. That's all that matters. You'll have a forge of your own in no time.
And when I do, I'll craft you the finest carving knife you have ever seen.
I wonder if we'll be able to come back to him later on into the game and actually get a carving knife from him. That'd be cool if so.
The finest fabric!
Yes, they're quite sought after.
Light meat and dark, fresh from the grill.
Let's do this next side quest. Do we have any more side quests, or is that just the ones that we have for now? Just the two.
Plates and pots, bowls and basins,
everything I've worked for, all those years of toil, every coin I've ever earned is tied up in this place.
Are you all right?
The baths are closed. Leave me be. On second thought, perhaps you are just what I need.
Might your services be for hire?
That depends on the job.
I'd have you save my business, the baths. The water's turned scalding hot and all the crystals in Dalimil wouldn't be enough to cool it. I've no doubt that my woes stem from the water's source. But I can't go and investigate for fear of my customers thinking I've abandoned the place. I'm bound to these baths in more ways than one. I beg of you, go to Dusnov Terraces. Tell me what you find there.
All right. I'll go and take a look.
Wonderful. It's not far. Leave the market by the south gate. The smell of sulfur will guide you the rest of the way. These baths are all that keep me from an ignoble end in a debtor's prison. My livelihood, my very life, is at stake.
Going the wrong way. Good lordy.
Sweet incense! Wax candle!
Finally, we'll be able to get what's owed us.
We should get going soon. Do you have water?
So we're gonna have to come up and around. And I can already see what's making the spring so hot.
Come on, girl, the gate's open now. We can...
We're gonna be having to fight some bombs. My favorite.
What the hell are those things?
Still didn't go far enough. Probably won't make it to the main quest today. But that's okay. We got the side quest done. And that's what matters.
By the flames. That explains the heat.
Ramu!
I'll not be outdone. Get up, my boy.
Man, bombs are so scary.
There's a good boy. Out of the frying pan.
More of them? Oof.
Better already.
Oh, got knocked out of that animation. Old Faithful. I believe that is a geyser's name in Yellowstone, but I could be wrong.
That's cooled things down a bit. Let's hope it's enough to keep the baths from boiling.
Ten whole gil. There's a treasure chest. I knew I'd seen it somewhere around here. We'll go back to that merchant. Don't know if it's worth riding our chocobo, to be honest. I mean, I guess we could, but I just don't see a real big reason to. I think what we'll do is, after turning in this side quest, if this is the end of that quest, by the way, we'll get up towards the main quest, and then we'll end the video, and then when we come back, we'll start on the main quest and do all that.
Come on, girl, it gets up.
We should get going soon. Do you have water?
Finally, we'll be able to get what's over.
There he is. The man who's... I was hoping we'd be seeing you again. The baths grow more bearable by the moment. It won't be long now before we are back to business as usual.
I'm glad to hear it.
Now, tell me this. What did you find at the terraces? What threatened to make me a pauper?
Not what I expected, that's for certain.
You tell a fine story. That's not to say I don't believe you, though. Creatures made of flame, eh? That's something new to worry about. But I've burdened you with my worries enough already. Here, a small something by way of thanks. Right. It's high time I got back to work. With a little luck, the day might yet be salvaged.
Ooh. That's cool. I think I need a Scarletti, I think it's called a Scarletti, to craft something.
Hanging lanterns, keep the darkness from your door.
Before we go to the main quest, I might want to go back to the hideaway and just see if I can craft that sword. Or not sword, I think it's armor.
Blue blood.
Clive? A Sangfornian deer.
Ooh. Grindstone. Yeah. Oh, we're actually taking the sword and upgrading it. That's cool. Yeah, let's do that.
Should last you a good while.
I think we already have the Drake's belt on. Okay, so we need the gelatinous mass, and we do have, it was something that we did need. We did need the Scarletti, but we don't have the gelatinous mass just yet. So we're just waiting on that.
Anything else?
Let's go back to our map, and then we'll come over here. And we'll head to the main quest, and before we get just about there...
This is no good.
I was hoping to get out of the heat.
We'll end the video. I have no clue where I'm going.
My carpets.
The most fragrant herbs and
fresh bread, warm from the oven.
God, everybody's talking at the same time.
Made from the stoutest stoneware.
Sweet incense. What wax candle?
Are you looking for something in particular?
Let's sell some of our stuff here. The materials.
Pleasure trading with you. Anything else I can take off your hands? Pleasure trading with you. Anything else I can take off your hands?
I want to sell any of the crafting stuff, so...
Go with Gilbert.
We should get going soon. Do you have water?
We'll just run. We're going to be ending the video before we get to the main quest anyway, so we'll just run it. Three desert roses. Bet those will be handy. We came from over there. And we can't get through there. So I think we're going to end it right before this bridge. And then after the bridge, we'll cross the bridge when we come back and start on the main quest. So with that being said, I want to start by telling everybody, thank you so very much for stopping by. I really do appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. If you didn't, hit the thumbs down button. Let me know why down in the comments below. It only helps the channel. Also, if you enjoy content just like this, be sure to subscribe or don't. I don't know. I'm not your dad. Do whatever you want. And like always, everybody, have a good morning, a good afternoon, or a good night, whatever time it may be in your part of the world. Mr. John Wayne, signing off.